A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th October, on the front page you have Economics Nobel for Abhijit to others. So this is Economics Nobel Prize for 2019, which has been awarded by a Royal Swedish Academy of Science, which decides on the prizes. It is the latest as such in the Nobel Prize list, because Economics Nobel Prize was started later. So it is it's called Sveriges Riksbank Prize in Economic Sciences in memory of Alfred Nobel. So the Nobel Prize in Economics, it has been awarded to Abhijit Banerjee, Esther Duflo and Michael Kremer. So this is for the experimental approach to alleviate global poverty. So Dr. Banerjee and Dr. Duflo are both affiliated with Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and Dr. Kremer works with Harvard University. So they three will equally share the prize money of 9 million Swedish krona. So the research they conducted has considerably improved ability to fight global poverty, is what the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences says. It says in just 2 decades, their new experimental-based approach has transformed development economics, which is now a flourishing field of research. So here you can see what they did is given. They sought to introduce a new approach to obtaining reliable answers about the most effective ways to combat global poverty. So rather than focusing on big picture questions, they divided the issue into smaller, more manageable and measurable questions. So this is the approach which they have used there, you know, and they showed that these smaller questions could be best answered through carefully designed experiments among the people who are the most affected. So you know what the result is called randomized controlled trials, which previously are used in the pure science as such, you know, clinical drug trials, as you understand. But they use such trials, you know, randomized controlled trials in economics to understand poverty. So for example, what they did was on schooling. Strong evidence now shows that the employment of contract teachers is generally a cost-effective way to improve student learning, while the impact of reduced class size is mixed. On health also, they showed that poor people's investment in preventive care has been shown to be very sensitive to the prices of health products or services. So generous subsidies should be given to such investments is what they have concluded. On credit also, they say growing evidence indicates that microfinance programs do not have the development effects that have been that many had thought when these programs were introduced on a large scale. Also, Dr. Banerjee and Dr. Duflo are married to each other, and they have a long history of conducting research together, and they have often collaborated with Dr. Kremer as well. So one of the major findings that the two had was that in developing countries, there is often a stark difference between technology and practices used by companies in the same economy and sector. So in developing economies, some companies use the latest technology and practices, while others use outdated production practices. These have been their findings, and they've been awarded Nobel Prize for this. And then here you have, if the media keeps quiet, terrorism will end. So this is Ajit Doval, National Security Advisor, who says that the judiciary treats terrorism cases on par with ordinary crimes. So, you know, it applies the same benchmarks and standards. So that's why he asks, where do we get witnesses in terror cases? There are very few witnesses in terror cases, and secondly, who will dare come and do this? So that is a challenge, major challenge in terrorism cases. And also he quotes former British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher, who had once said that if a terrorist takes action and the media is quiet about it, terrorism will end. So terrorists want publicity through a terror attack, they want publicity. So that is the intention of this statement, what this statement means. But then talking against terrorism talking about it, the media keeping it in highlight is also important. We cannot say that terrorism can be put under the carpet, and you know, we can imagine that it does not exist. Then below you have restored mobile lines recharge residents of Kashmir. So 40 lakh postpaid lines are back in service after 72 days in Jammu and Kashmir. And this is fast tags will work as Aadhaar to track vehicles. So this is Union Minister Nitin Gadkari, who has called fast tags, which is a device used to make automatic payments at toll booths. So this is equivalent to Aadhaar for vehicles, is what she says. And it will also be able to allow government to track movement of vehicles across the country. On page 4, you have government yet to decide on exempting two-wheelers from odd-even. So, the odd-even scheme is back in Delhi, and this time women have been given exemption, but two-wheelers have not. So, government has not yet given exemption to two-wheelers. So, given the current capacity of public transport, government may have no alternative other than exempting two-wheelers, which account for 64.43% of its vehicular population. So, because if two-wheelers are not allowed, then, you know, an odd-even scheme applies to them, then there's not enough public transport capacity. So, that's the point highlighted. On page 8, you have, she is in Capital's steering team, defying odds. So, this is Pranjal Patil, country's first visually challenged woman IAS officer. She is now Thiruvananthapuram's sub-collector. So, she's become the country's first visually challenged woman IAS officer. On page 9, you have Supreme Court seeks reply from Centre on RTI portals. So, this is regarding central government and 25 states who have been asked by the Supreme Court, who has given them 1 month's time to reply on a writ petition seeking a direction to establish RTI web portals across all states, so that citizens, especially those living abroad, can file RTI applications online. So, this they have been given 1 month's time to reply on this writ petition. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Economics of Poverty. So, this is regarding the Nobel Prize in Economics, which is the front page news today too, to Abhijit Banerjee, Esther Dullo and Michael Kremer. And the second editorial, A Man for All Seasons. So, this is regarding Saurav Ganguly, who is slated to become the BCCI chief now. So, it says Saurav Ganguly might just be the person Indian Cricket Administration needs now. So, that is also there on front page. The lead article, Financial Stability and the RBI. So, this article says that the slowing of economy suggests that central bank's stance on inflation may have impacted growth. So, this is because RBI has been saying that inflation is low. So, when inflation is low, that has impacted growth as such, because bi-monthly announcements by RBI. So, mandatory bi-monthly announcements take place on the future course of monetary policy, and these announcements offer forward guidance to economic participants so that they may plan their future. So, public would have perhaps been more interested in knowing how the RBI intends to respond to the unusually large number of instances of fraud that have surfaced in the financial sector too. So, RBI's reputation as a regulator has been affected by these frauds. So, role of RBI, how inflation control is put into effect, and how India's hawkish stand has resulted in, you know, how, you know, inflation targeting as was the defining function adopted for the central bank. So, while the entire world was reassessing the credibility of such target, inflation targeting, that is all detailed out here. And this is looking beyond the Rafale. So, it says even as Indian Air Force gets ready to welcome Rafale, you know, the new acquisition of 36 Rafale jets in ready condition, it says ad hocism should give way to strategic thinking. So, this is an ad hoc deal which has been finalized, but we need much more fighter jets. Then on op-ed page you have, is India still a minimally decent society? So, this says a fundamentally decent people, Indians may be irretrievably sunk if not put on the moral red alert. So, how morality has gone down is detailed out in this article. And this is regarding Turkey's military intervention in Syria, which has wide-ranging consequences beyond the war zone. This talks about this Turkish misadventure. Then this is framing laws for outer space. So, it says it is imperative that India's legal prowess be applied to situational complexities of space exploration. How there is a need for law on outer space too, and international law on outer space. So, there's already such a law, but then it needs to be strengthened. That is spoken about over here. Then on international page you have, Syrian forces step in to thwart Turkish onslaught. So, USA has withdrawn and Turkey has invaded northern Syria and is fighting against the Syrian Kurds as such. So, now Kurds have struck a deal with Russia-backed Assad government. That is Bashar Assad government of Syria. Earlier they were fighting with the United States. And US was against Assad government, but now Kurds have struck a deal with the Russian-backed Assad government after USA abandoned them. And now it will help them thwart the invasion by the Turkish Assad into northern Syria. And this is Spain jails 9 Catalan leaders, sparking protests. So you should know about Catalonia. This is a region in Spain which is demanding independence. So it's a region of unrest. On business page you have government working on revising spectrum prices. So auctioning would take place, including one for 5G airwaves. So this will be held in the current financial year is what the telecom minister says, and government is presently working on revising the spectrum prices because high prices have resulted in less of participation. So that should not be the case. Then this is Gujarat brings out a new port policy. So Gujarat policy, new port policy allows 33 private jetties to handle third party cargo. Then on the second business page, you don't have much news. Plus also the last page covers sports related news. So that's not important. So that is it. These are the news items. Thank you.